Now, if you're in Tel Aviv or thereabouts and you see drones flying overhead today, don't be alarmed. They're just demonstrations for the Autonomous Unmanned Systems and Robotics Expo taking place just south of the city. For more, let's head over to the Tel Aviv Stock Exchange to check in with our Middle East editor, Elliot Gotkin. Elliot.
Thanks, Anna. Yes, an appropriate place to be holding a conference on unmanned systems or drones, given that Israel is the world's largest exporter of drones and also the country that developed the modern day drone. Well, the man that led the team that did that is He's now the chairman of Tactical Robotics, and he joins me now. David, good morning to you.
Good morning, sir.
Now, at this conference taking place just south in Rishon LeZion, you're debuting today the Air Mule. Tell me about the Air Mule.
Okay, the Air Mule is, I would say, one of the last development in Israel, very revolutionary platform. Where if you are looking for about the platform, you will see a car, because all the propellers, which is in fact is a vertical and takeoff landing, is inside the fuselage, which is really revolutionary and will introduce, I think, a new revolution about air flying platforms.
And this is just a defensive drone. This is to help people at the front line.
It's defensive. It's just only for bringing cargo to the forces or to bring back also casualties.
And how do these drones that we're talking about now compare with the ones that you were first developing? I think the Scout was the first one that you developed.
Yeah.
I mean, very different.
Totally different, because at this time, 40 years ago, during the Yom Kippur War, the main objective was after the war to bring to the Israeli army a flying camera, just only could give them the information in real time. At this time, the platform was small. The weight was about 250 kilo. Today in Israel, 40 years after, and at this time we did not think about it, we have platform where the weight is 5 tons. Flying at 45,000 feet, which is totally different.
And very different applications as well. As you say, you first developed the Scout as a flying camera. Now, drones used in everything from trying to protect wild elephants to taking out terrorists in Pakistan or Afghanistan. I mean, how do you feel about the way these drones are used now, given that you initially developed them just as a flying camera?
As I said, it's like a snowball process. That means when we use it at the beginning in early 80, it was just only for intelligence, a pure camera, TV camera. Then after we introduced infrared during night, and then we introduced it as a platform to get information, electronic information, countermeasures, and so on. So in fact, it was an evolution. It was not a revolution. It was evolution of the use.
But is this an evolution you're kind of comfortable with? I mean, the drones that kind of, if you like, developed, evolved from ones that you developed, used to kill people, I suppose.
The United States, they use it just only to make some mission like this. But the main activity of the UAV is for information. I mean, and you are using it in peacetime more than wartime. And of course, in wartime you are using it, but the most the missions is during peacetime.
What's next for drones?
First, there is no limitation of to the human imagination. So you can find if we are speaking about air forces, I think that in 20, 30 years from now, we will have also UAV for air combat. That means
pilotless planes.
Absolutely, that means it will be combat between two airplanes. It's very difficult. Technically, it's very difficult, but we will arrive to this. But there is another point that we are speaking about aerial platform. But today we have ground platform and submarines or marine platform, and this has been happened when we discovered that robotics in the air can give a lot of information. So we are using now on the ground, on the sea.
Okay. David Harari, Chairman of Tactical Robotics. Thanks very much for joining us now. On the day that this large unmanned systems conference is taking place just south of Tel Aviv, the industry expected to be worth up to $82 billion by 2025. Back to you.
Elliot, thank you very much. I'm Middle East Editor Elliot Gotkin.